where we experiment everything that involves physics. This episode, we are going to discuss four new things about physics, which are rotational equilibrium, translational equilibrium, law of motion, and the center of gravity. Our first two experiments will be all about equilibrium. You don't know what equilibrium is? It's the state of a body, a physical system, at rest, or in unaccelerated motion, in which the resultant of all forces acting on it is zero. And the sum of all force about any axis is zero. The first type of equilibrium we will discuss is the rotational equilibrium.
Rotational equilibrium, or torque, is the moment of a force in the measure of a force a tendency to produce torsion and rotation about an axis, equal to the vector product of the radius vector from the axis of rotation to the point of application of the force and the force vector.
Next portion, let's experiment on the second type of equilibrium, translational equilibrium.
In the next portion, let's experiment on the second type of equilibrium, translational equilibrium. Translational equilibrium means that an object or its structure as a whole will not experience linear acceleration, and the vector sum of all the external forces acting on the structure must be zero. Basically, the object does not move.
In this experiment, Edsel wants to learn further about translational equilibrium by playing on the swing. The swing, as you all know, is hung by two chains. Forces with objects that are supported by chains do not touch the ground are called tension. Now that Edsel is sitting on the swing, the left chain is making a 65 degrees angle, while the right chain is making a 72 degrees angle. Edsel weighs 60 kilograms. The question raised is, what is the tension force exerted on both left and right chain?
The first thing we need to do is to draw a free body diagram, which is a pictorial representation that shows the forces in the model. The left chain, or tension 1, or T1, is at the left side of the diagram, making an angle of 65 degrees, while the right chain, or tension 2, or T2, is at the right side of the diagram, making an angle of 72 degrees. Since the two tensions are making an angle, they have to have both an x and y axis for each. So the tension 1, x axis, is placed at the downward left side of the diagram, and the y axis is placed at the upper right side, while the tension 2, x axis, is placed at the downward right side, and the y axis is placed at the upper left side.
There is naturally a gravitational force, so it would be placed on the bottom side of the diagram. Observe the diagram, then find the summation of the diagram's x-axis, which is tension 1x plus tension 2x is equal to 0. Tension 1x is negative because it was placed on the left side of the x-axis. Place tension 1x on the opposite side. So it will be a tension 2x is equal to tension 1x. If you know all about geometry, you should know that x is cosine while y is sine. So the equation will now be T1 cosine 72 is equal to T1 cosine 65. Divide cosine 62 by cosine 72, and T1 is equal to 0.73T2. Next, let's make a summation of y, which is T1y plus T2y minus Fg is equal to 0. Fg is negative because it is located on the bottom part of the y-axis.
Now it will be T1 sine 65 plus T2 sine 72 minus 588 is equal to 0. Put negative 588 on the opposite side. So it will be T1 sine 65 plus T2 sine 72 is equal to 588. Remember the answer of T1, which is 0.73T2. So let's substitute. 0.73T2 times sine 65 plus T2 sine 72 is equal to 588. Distribute, then it will become 0.66T2 plus 0.95T2 is equal to 588. Add both T2 and the sum will be 1.61T2. Divide 588 by 1.61. Then tension 2 is equal to 365.22 newtons.
let's go back to T1 again and substitute. Now that we have found T2, 0.73 times 365.22 is equal to 266.61 N. So the tension force exerted, or T2, is equal to 365.22 N, and T1 is equal to